Could I all ask you to find your seats, please? Sehr geehrte Frau Bundeskanzlerin, Honorable Prime Minister Modi, Mrs. Kamenini, Mr. Patel, Excellencies, Ladies and Gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to welcome you all to this Indo-German Business Summit of 2017. Dear Chancellor Merkel, dear Prime Minister Modi, thank you very much for supporting us in this business summit and giving us the honor of your presence. Dear Mrs. Kamenini, I'm looking forward and I thank you for the contribution to this summit that we hosted together, and also Mr. Patel, thank you very much, and looking forward to speak then after me. Ladies and gentlemen, things have changed quite a bit since we met 2 years ago in Hanover and in Delhi of 2015. I think it's fair to say that geopolitical uncertainties are rising and skepticism about globalization is worrying the business community in Germany. We are increasingly dealing with countries that are shutting off their markets. And for years, of course, we have taken globalization as something which we believe is granted to us. And now we see some of these beliefs at a risk. As German business community, we cannot be clear enough to say we want more, not less, global integration. We profit from globalization of market opening, and we strive to continue on this path together with India. We want to deepen our business ties with India because we believe that jointly we can improve things and jointly we can help the people in both countries. India is one partner which we follow very closely. With your current growth rates, you are one of the most interesting emerging markets in the world. And with your young population and the rising middle class, it is equally for us as production companies as for us as companies in the consumer market. As CEO of Voith, I represent a company that had been doing business in India since 1911. We have our own sites, and we are there with own manufacturing sites for 50 years. We have made important contributions to the Indian infrastructure and want to continue this way. And we consider us, as many of my colleagues from other German companies, we consider us as a truly Indian company. And I know from many of my colleagues that German business stands ready to invest even more in India. But for this, as we discussed during lunch together, it is important that we jointly work on areas which need to be improved, areas which we as partners can improve, where preconditions for better market access can be improved, and all of this for more investments and more business on both sides. Mr. Prime Minister, we clearly see the progress India has made under your term. You try to bring down corruption through various initiatives, and you are preparing India for its digital age with your campaign, Digital India. You develop your cities under the Smart Cities Program, a program where German industry is very interested. And we are looking forward, of course, to the big event of this year as we see the introduction of the GST all over India. Yet, please allow me to say, as always, more needs to be done. The cancellation of the Indo-German bilateral investment treaty makes especially the small and medium-sized German investor nervous. We all know that tension is not good for investments. Therefore, let us join forces in pushing together to reopen negotiation for the bilateral EU-India free trade agreement, including the investment protection portion, to ensure stable framework for future collaboration. Let us commit ourselves together to globalization and push together for ideal conditions for businesses in both of our countries. I'm looking now forward to your words, Mrs. Khamenei. I have learned you are for the first lady in this position for 100 years, and therefore we are listening with even more interest to what you have to say to us. Thank you very much.
Honorable Sri Narendra Modi ji, the Prime Minister of India, Her Excellency Dr. Angela Merkel, Chancellor of the Federal Republic of Germany, my colleague Dr. Leinhardt, who said such nice words, ministers, ladies, gentlemen, good afternoon. It's an honor for me to add my welcome on behalf of Indian industry to the Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Bhai Modi and Her Excellency Chancellor Merkel to this Indo-German Business Summit. Your personal encouragement and support is of immense value to industry on both sides. I take this occasion to compliment the Honorable Prime Minister for 3 outstanding years of reforms. Over the past 3 years, Indian industry has experienced major changes, and the results on the ground accompanied by a surge in business confidence are clear for the world to see. I would also like to thank Her Excellency Chancellor Merkel for her stewardship of the India-Germany economic engagement, and of course all that you do for the EU and your leadership. The present visit of our Honourable Prime Minister is a clear signal towards taking our bilateral relationship to a different dimension, and we from industry would play a positive role in taking this forward. The 2 leaders have been unequivocal in their support for globalization and for an open and engaged economy. The Confederation of Indian Industry was privileged to participate as a partner in the landmark visit of the Honorable Prime Minister to the Hannover Messe in 2015, where Make in India Lion was unveiled to the world. Since then, Make in India Lion has emerged as a dynamic symbol of the strengths of the Indian economy. Today, India is the fastest growing large economy in the world, with an average pace of growth of 7+% for the past decade. Higher growth will come, and it will come from diverse sources, including our infrastructure mission, the greater participation of women in the workforce, urbanization, and so on. The government has undertaken multiple reforms in direct and indirect taxation, fiscal management, and legislative framework. The Goods and Services Tax, GST, will be rolled out in just a month and will introduce huge efficiencies both for domestic and international trade. The ease of doing business has been taken up in mission mode by the central and state governments for facilitating investments and is actually bearing fruit. Besides Make in India, the government has launched Digital India for digital connectivity, Clean India for improving sanitation, Smart Cities for building 100 modern cities, and Clean Energy, just to name a few. These campaigns open up multiple new avenues for participation of German companies. India is now considered as among the top 5 priority countries by Germany. Growing 2-way trade investments and partnerships in collaborative manufacturing, insurance, equipment supply, and technology transfer mark our engagement today. In addition, Germany has been a preferred attractive destination for Indian investment. A recent CII study of Indian companies operating in Germany finds that they gain access to high quality technology, build innovation capability, and leverage Germany as a gateway to EU. The study shows that Germany is the second most attractive destination for Indian companies, but that was before Brexit, and all that might change. We would like to invite German companies to invest in India across our sunrise sectors, such as high-speed rail, new urban centers, ports, renewable energy, economic zones, etc. We are keen to learn from Germany about its successes in Industry 4.0 and replicate this in India. The cooperation of the two countries in small enterprises and especially in skills training also strengthens people-to-people connectivity for the development of India. I'd like to add that India last year added 3.7 million jobs to our workforce, and we plan on increasing this year on year for the next 7 years by 50% every year. So I thank the leaders of the two nations and assure you that this business community is vibrant, this business community is growing, and there will be more of us from small and large engaged from both India and Germany to ensure that the world becomes a much stronger economy. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. And I must say that I'm just the precursor for someone who's much more special, and this visionary leader has transformed India. May I request our Honorable Prime Minister of India to deliver his address. Thank you very much.
Her Excellency, Dr. Angela Merkel, leaders from global business community, ladies and gentlemen, it is a great pleasure to meet you all. It is an added pleasure to talk to you in the presence of an enlightened leader like Chancellor Merkel. In fact, I do not miss any opportunity of meeting her. I particularly recall my interactions during my visit to Hanover Fair in April 2015. India was a partner country in that fair. This was followed by Chancellor Merkel's visit to India in October 2015. Together, we have had several rounds of discussions with German and Indian CEOs. Today again, I can see a lot of energy and enthusiasm in this hall. I can also see a number of Indian CEOs present here. Friends, Germany is among India's most important partners, both bilaterally and in the global context. I'm very happy to see that the participation of German companies in India's growth story. It is equally heartening to see that Indian companies have also made their presence felt in Germany. Germany ranks 7th among foreign investor countries in India. Major sectors attracting FDI inflows from Germany are engineering, chemicals, and services. About 600 Indo-German joint ventures are presently operating in India. They provide employment to around 200,000 people. However, there is huge potential in India-Germany economic collaboration. Our economic partnership is still below its full potential. To enhance this, we in India are ready with open arms to welcome German companies. With a view to help the German companies, we have put in place a fast-track mechanism. A number of issues have already been resolved through this fast-track mechanism. We are doing it sincerely because we value German partnership a lot. Friends, we are on the path of making India a global manufacturing hub. Already a good economic system exists in India for manufacturing. India already offers a globally cost-competitive manufacturing ecosystem, a vast good of skilled professionals with knowledge and energy, world-class engineering education base and strong R&D facilities, rising GDP and purchasing power creating further growth in the domestic market, one of the most liberal FDI policy regime in the world, government's focus on easing the business environment further. Due to these trends, as said by UNIDO, India is already the sixth largest manufacturing nation in the world. To make it better, we are working hard on various enablers. Through our Make in India initiative, we are committed to transform India as a major player in the global value chain. Prime motive is creation of jobs and narrowing the gap between affluent and lower sections of society. Make in India has already created a strong impact. Germany is contributing in a big way in the success of Make in India. Particularly, India's participation as a partner country in the Hanover Fair has given a big boost to Indo-German partnership. During the Hanover Messe, specific areas of collaborations were mutually identified. This included manufacturing, skill development, railways, cleaning of rivers, renewable energy, education, science and technology. In addition, we are also implementing a strategic market entry support program since September 2015. It is called MIIM, Make in India Mittelstand. This is mainly to assist German Mittelstand companies in entering the Indian market. The MIIM program has been offering a wide range of business support services. The initiative has resulted in growing interest of German companies in India. The outcomes are that in this short period, 83 companies expressed interest to join the program. 73 companies have enrolled as official members. 47 are at advanced stage of investment implementation. Another ongoing and very successful program between India and Germany is the Indo-German Managers Training Program. This is for advanced training for business executives, especially from Indian SMEs. The program has resulted in increased investments, creation of new joint ventures, and increased B2B contacts between the two countries. Over 500 Indian managers have benefited by this program so far. In addition, there is a good weather already existing. Some examples are that Bosch, Siemens, BASF and SAP have started specific R&D operations exclusively in India.
Mercedes-Benz India inaugurated its second manufacturing facility in Chakan in July 2015. This will double the plant capacity to 20,000 units per annum. For our efforts, we have also received good global recognition. I would like to mention some of them. India remains a bright spot in the subdued economic landscape across the world. India has emerged as the fastest growing major economy the last 3 years with GDP growth rate of over 7%. We have moved up to 32 places in last 2 years in the Global Competitiveness Index of the World Economic Forum. This is the highest for any country. India also moved up 19 places on the Logistics Performance Index of 2016 of the World Bank. We have also moved up 16 places on the Global Innovation Index of WIPO in 2016. We are third among the top 10 FDI destinations listed by UNCTAD. These are just few examples. Our emphasis has been on reducing government and enhancing governance. I would give some examples. We are moving fast towards becoming a digital economy. GST is among the most historic reforms India has ever done, and it is going to be implemented from the next month. In the last 2 years, we have moved towards a low tax regime both on personal as well as corporate side. We have lowered the corporate tax from 30% to 25%, particularly for new investments and smaller ventures. New laws and institutions for bankruptcy and insolvency as well as IPR and arbitration are now in place. More than 7,000 reforms have been implemented on the front of ease of doing business. 36 white industries have been taken out of the requirement of environmental clearances. Similarly, more than 50 items have been taken out of defense list. Validity period of industrial licenses has been increased up to 15 years. Custom clearance has been made 24/7 at 19 ports and 17 air cargo complexes. Incorporating a company along with allotment of DIN number, PAN number, TAN number and the CIN number is now just one day affair. Power connection is provided within a time frame of 15 days. India's ranking is now up by 111 places on getting electricity parameter of World Bank. We have examples in addition to thousands of reforms done by the states. Along with the federal government, the states have also taken keen interest in implementing such reforms. I'll give you some examples. Here, I'm mentioning about some states, but due to a sense of competition, the trend of reform is spreading fast to all the states. Reforms include 100% implementation of single window system for payments and approvals in 16 states. 100% implementation of e-filing of the tax returns in 13 states. Automated online building plan approval in 13 states. E-filing system for commercial disputes have been implemented in 11 states. Specialized commercial courts have been established in district level in 13 states. Friends, now India has one of the most liberal FDI policy regime in the world. More than 90% of the foreign investment flows are under automatic route. Last week, we formally decided to abolish the Foreign Investment Promotion Board, which was made in 1990 to examine the FDI proposals. The idea is to expand the engagement of overseas investors in the Indian economy. Due to this approach, our FDI outlook has been ranked highly positive by various international agencies. There has also been huge growth in the FDI inflows in the last 3 years and has now reached to $60 billion in 2016-17. Friends, India is a big country. Hence, nothing is enough when it comes to development. We have many dreams, and the dreams are big. But we have short timeline, and this is your opportunity. The opportunity range from building millions of houses to setting up thousands of smart cities, modernizations of railway networks and stations to setting up of a high-speed rail corridors, generation of renewable energy to construction of transmission and distribution network. In addition, there is an ever-growing need for national highways, bridges, and mass urban transportation systems, schools, hospitals, and skill training institutions. We are trying to empower our people to realize this potential through our campaigns like Digital India and Skill India. To tap the youth energy fully, we have launched the Startup India and Stand Up India campaigns. Chancellor Merkel and friends, when I spoke in April 2015, our processes of reforms had just started. Now I can safely say that we have completed sizable part of it. However, we are committed to do more and more in a faster and a better manner. I strongly believe that we should create institutional networks to understand and advocate such reforms. This is necessary to leverage the underlying economic potential of our two countries. At the end, I invite more and more German colleagues and companies to India. Our direction, desire, and dreams create tremendous business opportunity. Never before, India was so much ready for business. We are on a take-off stage. Moreover, our domestic values and alert judicial system will ensure the safety of your investments. I assure you that we will work hard and we will work hand in hand with you to make your efforts successful. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you a lot.
Sehr geehrter Herr Premierminister Modi, sehr geehrte Frau Kamineni, sehr geehrter Herr Pate, sehr geehrter Herr Lienhardt, meine Damen und Herren. Ich freue mich natürlich heute mit dem indischen Premierminister beim Deutsch-Indischen Wirtschaftsforum mit dabei zu sein. Ich möchte mich zuallererst bei den indischen Wirtschaftsverbänden und dem Asien-Pazifik-Ausschuss der deutschen Wirtschaft bedanken, die diese Konferenz auch vorbereitet haben. Und lieber Narendra Modi, sehr geehrter Herr Premierminister, ich möchte Ihnen ganz ausdrücklich danken. Sie haben dieses Treffen hochrangiger Vertreter der indischen und deutschen Wirtschaft unterstützt. Und Sie haben auch darauf Wert gelegt, dass wir nicht nur die Regierungskonsultationen durchführen, sondern eben auch die wirtschaftspolitischen Gespräche fortsetzen, einmal beim Mittagessen und jetzt bei dieser Konferenz. Und das unterstreicht noch einmal, dass Sie Wort halten, dass Sie zu dem stehen, was Sie vor 3 Jahren angekündigt haben, was Sie so eindrucksvoll auf der Hannover Messe auch uns Deutschen hier gesagt haben. Und wenn wir uns heute anschauen, wie Indien dasteht, dann kann man sagen, es hat überdurchschnittliche Wachstumsraten und zuletzt wieder mit deutlich mehr als 7%. Und wir wollen natürlich als Bundesrepublik Deutschland, ich darf das, glaube ich, im Namen der deutschen Wirtschaft sagen, ein Teil dieser Erfolgsgeschichte sein, die Sie in Indien schreiben. Unser bilaterales Handelsvolumen hat sich in den letzten zehn Jahren mehr als verdreifacht. Wir liegen jetzt mit einem Handelsvolumen von derzeit 17 Milliarden Euro ganz gut, aber wir haben da auch noch Luft nach oben. Deutschland ist der mit Abstand wichtigste Handelspartner aus der EU in Indien. Aber wir wollen nicht nur handeln, sondern wir wollen auch investieren. Und deutsche Unternehmen sind in Indien als Investoren gut vertreten. Es sind mittlerweile über 1600 sowohl mittelständische Unternehmen als eben auch große Industriebetriebe und damit verbunden sind 400.000 Arbeitsplätze vor Ort. Und wir haben heute bei den Regierungskonsultationen, die Wirtschaftsministerin ist hier, der Energieminister ist da, der Forschungsminister ist da, nochmal unterstrichen, wie wir sozusagen zwischen Politik und Wirtschaft auch Hand in Hand gehen wollen, um unseren Rahmen für die Zusammenarbeit auch zu vergrößern. Dabei ist die Palette der Branchen breit. Sie reicht von der Automobilindustrie über den Luftverkehr bis hin zum pharmazeutischen Bereich. Und ich glaube, deutsche Unternehmen können sich mit ihrem Know-how als wichtige Partner bei der Modernisierung der indischen Wirtschaftsstrukturen und Infrastrukturen einbringen, sei es beim Verkehrsnetz, sei es beim Energiesystem oder allgemein bei der Stadtentwicklung. Wir haben heute sehr ausführlich darüber gesprochen, dass das auch alles eingebettet sein muss in eine Umgebung, die Menschen nicht erschreckt über die Geschwindigkeit der Modernisierung, sondern die Menschen, Arbeitnehmerinnen und Arbeitnehmer mitnimmt. Und die Bundesregierung unterstützt mit ihrer neuen Strategie zur Begleitung der deutschen Industrie natürlich auch gerade solche Möglichkeiten, bei wichtigen Großprojekten in Drittländern mitzumachen. Wir haben in vielen Gesprächen festgestellt, dass wir dazu nicht ausreichend international gut aufgestellt sind. Wir haben versucht, hier Verbesserungen vorzunehmen und wir glauben auch, dass wir dabei voranschreiten können und sind ja auch im Bereich der Eisenbahn zum Beispiel dabei, hier unsere Machbarkeitsstudien voranzubringen. Ich bin mir mit Premierminister Modi einig, wie wichtig es auch und gerade beim Verkehrsträger Schiene und man stelle sich die indischen Dimensionen vor, dagegen ist ja Deutschland nur ein Punkt sozusagen auf der Landkarte, wie wichtig es ist, gerade den Verkehrsträger Schiene zu erneuern und wenn wir bei ihm auch die Weichen für neue Zusammenarbeit stellen könnten bei diesem Verkehrsträger, wäre das sicherlich fast ein symbolischer Akt. Wir wissen aber auch, um ein gutes Klima zu schaffen, gehört es dazu, auch das Bildungswesen zu entwickeln. Skill India ist einer der wesentlichen Pfeiler der Strategie des Premierministers. Und hier ist Deutschland mit seinem dualen Berufsausbildungssystem, glaube ich, ein guter Partner. Und wir können dies in den verschiedenen Formen von Unternehmen sozusagen ausprobieren, auch im Bereich der Start-ups, also im ganzen Bereich, in dem Digitalisierung eine Rolle spielt, wo Indien ja sehr hoch entwickelt ist. Wir haben Programme zur Managerweiterbildung, die auch indischen Managern Einsicht in unsere Möglichkeiten des dualen Berufsausbildungssystems geben und gerade heute haben wir die Verlängerung dieses Programms auch wieder beschlossen. Im Blick auf die Digitalisierung sind natürlich die Informationstechnologien eine besondere Spezialität der Wirtschaft. Nicht umsonst war ich bei meinem letzten Indien-Besuch in Bangalore zusammen mit dem Premierminister eine sehr eindrucksvolle Reise. Und ich glaube, gerade in der Kombination Ihrer Fähigkeiten und der Fähigkeiten der deutschen Wirtschaft im Bereich Industrie 4.0 lassen sich auch noch einmal große Mehrwerte für unsere beiden Länder erzielen. Wir haben heute viel über Standortbedingungen gesprochen und deshalb verfolgen wir natürlich den Reformkurs von Indien sehr aufmerksam. Ich bin dankbar darüber, dass wir ein Fast-Track-Verfahren entwickelt haben. mit dem wir dort, wo es hakt, wo es Schwierigkeiten gibt, sofort einschreiten können und auch die Probleme lösen können. Das hat in vielen Fällen jetzt schon sehr gut geklappt. Und wir haben heute auch gelernt, dass es auch von indischer Seite an uns in Deutschland Wünsche und Erwartungen gibt. Und auch hier wollen wir natürlich intensiv mit Ihnen zusammenarbeiten. Die Standortpolitik insgesamt ist natürlich sind das harte Verhandlungen, natürlich muss jede Seite dort auch die Interessen einbringen. Wir haben auch über bürokratische Hürden der Europäischen Union gehört, auch so etwas müssen wir zur Sprache bringen. Insofern sieht man also, dass es durchaus eine sehr offene und intensive Diskussion war. Offene und freie Märkte, das ist auch ein Thema unserer G20-Präsidentschaft. Ich möchte dem Premierminister danken, dass er zweimal innerhalb weniger Wochen nach Deutschland kommt, einmal jetzt zu den deutsch-indischen Regierungskonsultationen, und dann noch einmal zu den G20-Treffen Anfang Juli und möchte mich auch bedanken für die gute Zusammenarbeit im Rahmen der Vorbereitungen mit Indien. Und ich denke, dass die Anwesenheit hier der vielen Unternehmensvertreter auch deutlich macht, dass es ein großes Interesse an den deutsch-indischen Wirtschaftsbeziehungen gibt, dass diese Wirtschaftsbeziehungen zwar einerseits wirtschaftliche Tätigkeiten sind, bei denen jede Seite natürlich auch etwas verdienen will und etwas gewinnen will, dass das aber eingebettet ist in eine gute politische Kooperation, in eine vertrauensvolle Kooperation, die sich in den letzten 3 Jahren entwickelt hat. Und sehr geehrter Herr Premierminister, lieber Narendra Modi, dafür möchte ich mich ganz persönlich bedanken. Danke, dass Sie hier waren und sind. Danke den Vertretern der Wirtschaft aus Indien, dass Sie zum Teil eine weite Reise auf sich genommen haben. Und ich hoffe darauf, dass dies ein gutes Zeichen ist dafür, dass wir unsere Beziehungen weiter intensivieren werden, zum Wohle unserer beider Länder, zum Wohle Indiens, aber auch zum Wohle Deutschlands. Herzlichen Dank.
Excellency Dr. Angela Merkel, Chancellor of Federal Republic of Germany, the chief architect of New India, our Honorable Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi ji, Dr. Hubert Leinhardt, the President of APA, my colleague Shobhana, President CII, industry leaders from Germany and India, ladies and gentlemen. It's an honor for me to be here to present a vote of thanks. I would like to salute our two global leaders for their foresight and vision. What we heard from them today provides a clear roadmap for the future of Indo-German partnership in the realm of business and economy. At a time when protectionist tendencies are rising globally, the affirmation of our two leaders to openness, greater trade, investment and exchange of technology for mutual growth provides businesses on both sides much needed confidence. While the priorities have been indicated, I would only reiterate that few that merits immediate attention. Both of our nation, there is a clear focus on jobs and generating employment. Startups have a key role to play. With Bangalore and Bombay having world-class startup ecosystem, we see a clear case of collaboration. Next is manufacturing. With advent of Industry 4.0, manufacturer has undergone a sea change. Indian IT services can be a key enabler to support the transition of German industry just as they contribute in India. In infrastructure, we heard our Prime Minister Modi ji talk about some of the largest projects globally that we are under implementation in India today. German firms can play a vital role in the areas such as railways, airports, ports, power, and digital infrastructure sectors. The mega industrial corridor undergoing implementation in India will be the corridor of prosperity for our coming generation.
And we invite our friends from Germany to join the development journey. In fact, the success of partnership can be replicated in other parts of the world, most notably Africa, and FICCI has set up a dedicated task force for this. Ladies and gentlemen, the people of India and Germany have reposed their faith in their leadership, Prime Minister Modi ji and Chancellor Merkel. The recent electoral results at state and regional levels are the testimony of this. We are sure that both the economies, the reforms momentum, will gain further momentum and bring in new opportunities for all of us. We work not only for the industry, we work also for the German think tank. With Conrad Foundation, we work through the exchange of MPs and in terms of bringing the both legislature together. Indian industry stands ready to work with our German counterparts to translate the vision of our leaders into reality and contribute to the era of shared prosperity. With these words, I once again thank Prime Minister Modi ji and Chancellor Merkel and we look forward for the continuous guidance of theirs in time to come. Thank you very much.